Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to the channel. You're watching Code Ray, and if you're new on my channel, I help you to navigate and succeed in your tech career. So make sure to keep watching if you're thinking about going to tech, or if you're already in tech and you're trying to just advance your career. Before we get started, I just want to say that this video is sponsored by Wix, so huge shout out to them. And in this video, I will be teaching you how to make a project website on Wix, which would help your resume and help you getting a job and also starting off if you have a project that you want to work on. Okay, so if you guys have ever tried to make a side project from scratch or with a few friends, using Wix is a really great way to kick off your side project in order to launch it without having to reach out to developers to create a website, because that might take a lot of time and effort and money. And in that time period, you could be using your resources to basically go out and actually launch the project and have a lot more time to see if the public like the project. This not only allows you to create a side project a lot more effectively, it allows you to create a project that will look really good on your resume, especially for recruiters who are looking at the things that you've done. So like if someone else has a resume in which there's stuff that they can't really show, it looks a lot better on your resume if you have stuff that you can show for it. As a student, I found it really helpful to use a website like Wix in order to create the side project online, because if I had to start one by myself, it would take a lot of time and effort. And in that time period, I could be doing other stuff, including expanding out the scope of the project or even working on technical interviews. Whether your project is just a website or it's a platform to better the community, using Wix is an extremely helpful way to take off and launch your project, because it would allow it to reach out to larger communities, which will allow you to basically gauge how effective your current project is. So today I will be showing you how to make a side project out of one of the projects that I made before called Charitability. I'm going to be making this project on Wix. And essentially, Charitability is a platform that allows people to connect with various donations around the world. So it allows people to find out about donations and funds that they otherwise wouldn't be able to find out about. All right, so before I get started, if you want to create a project website using Wix too, make sure to check out my link. It's gonna be in the description below. It's gonna help me a lot and help this channel a lot. So make sure you check it out. But without further ado, let's get started. So first you're gonna choose what the website should be, and we're gonna choose a business website because that's the one that we want to make. And then you're gonna click edit template. There's a ton of templates that you can choose from, which is super amazing. We're actually gonna go with the ad tech startup because that's one of my favorite templates to use because it's very clean. And so you can just go on it and click edit, and then it'll create a whole thing for you. As you can see, if you're following along, there's so many different things that are on this website. There's like different tabs and everything that you can change. So we're gonna go about starting off by changing the title and each individual thing to make it balance for our website. So we're gonna call it Connecting People to Charities, and we're gonna see what looks good. And essentially, like, a lot of the text that you can basically update, you don't really have to use the fonts that they give you. You can use any fonts that you want. But I would suggest playing around with a lot of the tools that they have. Currently, I like the fonts that they give in the website, so I'm gonna start with those, and I'm just gonna update the things that are there. Also, it's really cool, the buttons, you can edit as much as you want. So in this case, we're going to make the buttons how we want it to be. And then there's just a lot of things that are really editable that I find to be super helpful. So to start off, we're gonna edit the title at the top. We're also going to drag the top down because it is covering a bit of the tabs. Very nice. And as you can see, I want to create like a bold font to the people in charities, just make them more prominent so people can see that. Also, you can input images. So for this, I don't like the images that they put on. So in this case, I want to add an image to my website. So what I do is go to the sidebar, click add, go to image, and then I could get to choose to upload an image to my website. And with this step, I have some pre-uploaded images. I just choose the image to upload, and I can put it directly onto my website. It's a cool vector field that I found, a vector image that I found, and it's called donation, so it's highly awesome. And as you can see, there's a lot of things that you can change, including the background. You can change the top background and this current background. So I tried out a few backgrounds, but I currently like the background they have, so I'm gonna keep it there. I love the colors and the resolution that comes with it. Also, as you can see, you can update the button to show different animations, which I think is pretty cool, so I created an animation for it. And then there's a lot of things that you can customize with the menu section. So I'm gonna look at these various menu sections, and you can look at them too, but take out the ones that you don't need. So currently, I don't need a lot of these menu sections, so I'm going to take those down. and move them around. So I'm looking into just having a home and about the charities I can donate to, and just maybe having like a sign in or a get started. So that's what I'm currently doing. Deleting the rest of the things that you don't need. And you honestly don't have to use everything that they give you. Just make sure you use enough where you can best portray your own website. And as you can see, the anchor sign, it means it's not a whole page. It's like one specific part, so that's anchored down there. But yeah, it looks good so far. And so we're going to try to navigate back to the homepage and start work on that. And so there's other things that are up there, including like a profile page that I want to take off because I'm currently not able to basically have everyone have a profile. This is more like a sign up.
So in this case, I'm actually going to delete some of the menu options for the nav bar because I don't have a demo and I don't need to sign up anywhere.
Yeah, so the next section, I'm going to be looking into how to make it like what I want for the next sections. So a lot of these things you can just delete. A lot of the specific things are called strip. You can just take a strip out, you can just move it around. So a lot of these times I'm gonna be moving around to make it look like the best way that I can. And so I'm gonna start editing a lot of the things that are able to be edited, including the text at the bottom and all of that. So like all of these things, they look really good and I definitely want to be able to change them. And so that's like the beauty of it currently, because you can really customize all the things that you don't want. So basically like I'm gonna drag out charitability, and as you can see, they show you like which specific text you're highlighting or how much the screen is able to be shown to specific sizes. So we're just gonna put in some information here, take that out, you know, change the specific buttons that it has. And keep in mind right now, I am trying to make it the best design that I can be. I currently like a lot more simplistic stuff and minimalistic stuff, so I'm gonna take away all of that because I think having a lot of information on the page really deviates from the meaning or the message that is currently being shown. So basically take those away, see where that goes. And now I'm dragging it to show like where I kind of want it. So like it's really editable. This looks really good to me, but there's a lot of things that could be done. See, I currently don't like that, so I'm gonna drag it around. It tells you that you dragged it out of the grid line, so that's bad, so I'm gonna update that. But dragging it back inside, that looks pretty good. Just play around with it and see what you like. Make sure to do an outline of like what you currently like. They have a really good templates for you. So I'm gonna change the contact information, change all of that. And that looks pretty good. So now a lot of this is just editing it with your own information. I currently like what they have, a lot of the things that they have already. It just really is super, super flexible as a sense. Yeah, so like currently going forward into just editing the title, Meet Charitability. And in this way, I try to deliver as much information I can about charitability on the front page of the site, because that is the site that everyone is gonna see first. So helping you reach out to charities. They have a lot of these like images that I want to take out too. So I'm just gonna start editing text first and talking about how I should be able to, you know, help people donate to a lot of different places. And I think that's really helpful for my community specifically, because a lot of people want to donate money, but they don't know where to donate it to, and they don't know what those companies do.
All right, so I'm gonna add another image to my website. I'm just gonna go to the left, click add, click image, and then I'm gonna be able to upload an image. And so in this case, I'm gonna upload one of my new images and then put it directly on the website.
Dragging stuff up is really helpful. And one thing that I find is really helpful with this is that like you can also drag more than one element at a time. So in this case, I'm dragging one element at a time, but I'm gonna start showing you how I can drag more than one element. So if you go like that and you highlight all of them, you can drag all of them together. And yep, so basically mainly I'm gonna just like edit each of these and see how it works. You definitely can add as much customization as you want. There's different stuff on the sides to allow you to add this customization, but I would more focus on the message that you're trying to portray, because all of these look really good. It's mainly about how you're able to portray that message from your site. So as you can see here, there's a lot of the text settings that you can use. I'm currently using the same ones that they give you because I really like it. I like having the picture to the left and the person to the side, and then showing you like the different steps that you can take in order to apply to charitability and all of this information. Also, I would highly suggest using vector images or images that don't have like a background, because it's a lot easier for them to see it on the page with a white background. So like if you use images that have other stuff in the back, it would be a lot harder to see. Some places that would be helpful to find images would be like vector icons that can change sizes, or like just different Google images, Adobe images. A lot of these are free, some of them are paid, but it really depends on how much effort you want to put into your site. Yep, so going to also update these. There's some things that I want to take out from here, like all of these resources and features, so I'm gonna be able to take those out. And then we'll see what happens. So I took that whole background out. I basically want to have like specific parts that I need and specific parts that I don't need, because if you have a really long homepage, it really deviates from your meaning, because people would take a look at it and be really confused about what you're actually trying to show. But in this case, you can see that you can toggle between strip pages, and in this case, I'm going to just drag everything up to make sure it matches. And as you can see, there's also this giant white space that I want to get rid of. And so what you can actually do is you can actually just drag up your whole strip and it takes away the white space. And as you can see, I'm doing that now. And yeah, it looks pretty good. It looks pretty good so far. I'm just gonna be editing some of the things on here, so we can fast forward that a little bit. One of the things that I really like is also that you can choose different textiles, and I actually really like the textiles they give, so I'm gonna keep those. But if you want different textiles, you should be able to choose it. I would suggest making a blueprint of the whole website that you want and everything you want first before making it, so that you know where everything should go. So this is the place where I am able to ask them about choosing a charity, which is super cool. And at this point, I'm just making sure everything lined up, and just talking about the same things that they talk about. So they give some really good ideas for sections that you should have in your website. So that's also what I really like about Wix, is that they have some of the best templates around, and also they have really good ideas for like things that you need on your website, because they have web designers that work on this. And if you don't have a web designer, I would suggest following just what they have. So just editing this right now. Everything looks good so far, I like it. Now we're gonna try to work on the about page. So the about page, you can see, is like the mission, what it's about, the story. So I also really like the images that they used. I think like stock images work really fine. You don't have to take, it's good to take images for yourself, but in the beginning you can always use stock images. We'll probably update this as we go along. Connecting people to charities, about section, and we can talk about the mission that we have. So in this area, I'm gonna be talking about like the mission and the purpose and also the story. And I think it's pretty important to talk about that, because it just shows like how you were able to create this website, and it just shows that you're a genuine person and you care about the community versus just having like a fake website for other people to see. So we can fast forward this too. But yeah, I'm not trying to write too much for each one, because when people see like, I think when people see a lot of paragraphs on the website, they're actually turned off by what it's there. So like having like a really good, like solid short sentence to describe each like section is really important because it allows people to grasp the main idea without losing focus on the whole website itself. So I actually started this website as a group of students working on a project, and we thought that it would be super cool to bring charities to people, and that's what we started doing. Okay, so now that it's finished, everything looks pretty good. I'm just gonna align everything. And I love how they give you already a form already to basically connect with charitability. There's a lot of different topics or a lot of different pages that are out there. We're gonna work on basically the next page, which is the charities. As you can see that the get started is basically this like anchor at the bottom. So every time you press that, it's gonna go to the bottom, which is super helpful. You can see that there's like profile information that we currently don't really need to use, so we can get rid of it later on. But it looks really good if we want to help start people creating their profiles. That's exactly what we want it to be look like. But yeah, so we want to talk about our charities, and we're gonna talk about all the charities that we actually go through, and this list is gonna be updated, which allows people to basically create a profile and look at the charities and look at more information about each of the charities and see how they, like see which charities they want to donate to. Because a lot of times, charities actually donate different amounts of money to different groups of people. So like, not all, they don't all donate the same percent of your money to funds, and a lot of charities actually take those funds because they're a nonprofit organization. But yeah, this would really help with smaller charities. So I'm basically going to just like take away everything and start with creating these different charity categories. I really like the boxes they made, which is super cool. It's awesome in order to be able to just easily edit everything. And there's also different categories, so as time goes on, we can also add to this. So that's gonna be super helpful to basically just like improving our whole platform in general, because a dynamic platform is much better than a static one, so we want to be able to update this as much as we can. So currently we have about 3 to 4 for each category, but that's definitely gonna grow as we grow as a platform. These are all really cool charities that you can also donate to also, but this is an idea that really allowed me to open up to see like what, there's way more charities out there than just Red Cross and UNICEF. But yeah, it looks pretty good and we have everything in. And so if you can take a look at the navigation, we go back to about, everything looks pretty good in about. And this is what I want my website to look like. And the homepage looks the best because we want people to start pressing on the get started to go to the connect to us button so that we're able to basically connect them with a charity. And so that's the end of my presentation. This is a website that we're actually probably gonna use out for a side project. But once again, if you want to create a project website just like this to showcase for your resume, or you're creating a side project in itself, make sure to use my tracking link in the description. It's gonna help me a lot with this YouTube channel and help me make more videos. But thank you so much for watching, and hopefully you guys are able to make one too.